Your attention here is the fantastic live show. It dates back to their days in Zoo TV when they changed live performances forever by incorporating multi-screens and on-stage cameras. This time around, they fabricated some of the biggest see-through LED video screens that you will ever see. They are so big, in fact, that U2 perform inside the structure. These mammoth screens are created right here in Montreal by Seco Technologies. Joining us is Linda Etchison, VP of Finance and Administration. Tell me a little bit about how this relationship got underway with you guys.
Well, we've been doing this for over 20 years, and we first worked for U2 on their Pop Mart tour back in 1997. So Seco is known for creating and making the impossible happen. We're very innovative, and we work in a tight-knit community, so we have a great reputation, and the production companies keep coming to us.
I got to tell you, a lot of the people that we've been interviewing today were saying that this is like the fifth member of the band. What has been the band's reaction, the production management's reaction to these screens?
It's been very positive, and what's really amazing is the band gets to express themselves and interact with the content on the screen. So it's really amazing. We have positive feedback, and although we don't have a specific quote from Bono himself, I'd love to hear from him, but positive feedback from the production team.
That is simply amazing. Anybody that has seen the live show or will see the live show will know what I'm talking about. We're going to have more for you at 11. Linda, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And we will be back at the 11 o'clock with Alicia, Jamie, to talk more about tonight's performance and amazing fan reaction. U2 in Montreal, fourth night, wrapping up tonight, and then it's over. The Innocence and Experience Tour wraps up. That's it for Sermon in the City. Jamie, back to you.
All right. Thanks for that, Jay. We'll see you at 11 tonight. We'll be watching.